our students. If you have a veteran who's a guest, that is a family member or friend that's here with you today, could you quietly get up and you may come and sit on the floor right in front of your veteran? That way you can sit with them. Good morning, and welcome to our special guests here today. For those of you who don't know me, I think most of the kids know me, but for those of you who are guests, I'm Louisa Welch, and I'm the principal here at Bayside Elementary. We are delighted to have you join us this morning to help us celebrate the observance of Veterans Day. It is my hope that our assembly this morning shows just how much we truly appreciate our veterans and the sacrifices they have made to our country. When we say today that we thank you for your service, we recognize that your service to our country includes not only the job that you did as a member of the military or continue to do, but we also thank you for the sacrifices made beyond that. At times, that could have been putting yourself in harm's way, or it could have meant spending weeks, months, or even years apart from family and loved ones, all for the purpose of protecting our freedoms that we enjoy every day here in the United States. My family has a strong connection to military service. As a matter of fact, as a child, I remember the bumper stickers on the back of my parents' car. On one side, it read, "Fly Army." On the other, it read, "Dive Navy." And we were never quite sure who to root for in the Army-Navy game, because I always felt like I was selling out one of my brothers. So this celebration is particularly close to my heart, and I'm pleased to continue what has become a tradition here at Bayside to hold this assembly to thank our veterans and active duty military for their service to our country. We have a wonderful lineup for you this morning, and we hope that you enjoy it. Before we continue, I'd like to recognize a few people for all they have done to prepare for today. I'd like to thank Ms. Kathy Fowler and our Veterans Day Committee, and thank you also to our PTA for their continued support and providing the refreshments for our veterans this morning. Thank you so much. Thank you again for being here and for joining us today. And now I welcome our local Boy Scouts and Girl Scouts who will present our flag and lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. After the pledge, please remain standing as Mrs. White leads our Bayside chorus in the singing of our national anthem.
morning, everyone. I too have a strong connection to the military, as I am the daughter and sister of Air Force veterans. So that's near and dear to my heart as well. We have veterans and active duty service members present today. A veteran is someone who has served in our military and is no longer in the military. The military is people who have served in the Army, Navy, Air Force, Marines, and the Coast Guard. Our active duty service members that are here are someone who are currently in one of those branches of the armed services and are still serving our country. So thank you all for your service. Now we're going to have our chorus sing American Tears and the Spirit of America.
Sometimes I think about America.
to introduce Colonel Clark. Colonel Clark earned his Bachelor of Science in Aeronautical Science with a minor in Aviation Safety from Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University, Daytona Beach, Florida, and received his commission from Officer Training School at Maxwell Air Force Base, Alabama. Prior to his current position, Colonel Clark was Commander, 756th Air Refueling Squadron, Joint Base Andrews, Maryland. He also held various leadership positions, including Chief Pilot, Chief of Group Training, Chief of Weapons and Tactics, and Flight Commander with the 459th Operations Group, J.B. Andrews, Maryland. His dates of rank, he was commissioned as a second lieutenant June 12, 1998. His current rank is Colonel, effective August 1st, 2017. For his first assignment, he reported to the 459th Air Fueling Wing, J.B. Andrews, Maryland, where he flew the C-141 Star Lifter for 5 years before converting to the KC-135 Stratotanker. His education background: in 1993, he earned his Bachelor of Science, Aeronautical Science, Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University, Daytona Beach. 2013, he earned his Master's of Military Operational Art and Science, Maxwell Air Force Base, Alabama. Colonel Clark's combat experience is he's a veteran of the Operations Fundamental Justice, Iraqi Freedom, Enduring Freedom, Inherent Resolve, and numerous other operations and contingencies in support of the nation's security strategy. For his flight experience, he has more than 4,400 flight hours, and the military aircraft that he has flown are the T-37, T-1, C-141, and the KC-135. He is a lifetime member of the Veterans of Foreign Wars, and currently he is the Emergency Preparedness Liaison Officer. He engages in state and federal homeland security planning and training exercises and national special security events. So let's welcome Colonel Clark to Bayside.
That wonderful introduction. I have to say that this is a little bit overwhelming. It's amazing. The Boy Scouts and the Corps did a wonderful job, and I want to start off. I had a little bit of help with developing my speech. My daughter here, she's a little bit of a speech writer, so she developed this just a short amount of talk that's right here in this, but unfortunately, honey, I've decided to go a little bit off the script, and I talked with Mr. Jones, and we started making a little bit more of a detailed speech that we have here, and there'll be a short quiz afterwards that will be waiting for you guys all back in the classroom. I'd love you guys to appreciate all that. What do you guys think? Can I get a round of applause for that? This is Welch and the entire staff and faculty for inviting me to speak and for inviting all the veterans. I also wanted to send a special thanks out to Mrs. Fowler for setting up this, and the Parent Teacher Association for coordinating all this. I also wanted to give a special thanks to all veterans that are attending. I'm truly humbled to be up here on the stage and with all the other veterans that are here. It's an amazing collection of people. It's my third year coming, and we're getting to know each other a little bit better. It's a little great thing to keep coming. And I also wanted to give a special shout out to retired sergeant from the Marines, Albert Miller. I believe he was right over there, 88 years old. Yeah. Shout out to Mr. Lawrence Bernard of the U.S. Army. Is he here today? Thank you. Veterans Day celebration, so, again.
Thank you.
But really, without saying, the best part of this event is interacting with the students and was amazing, and it's just really just an honor to be here. I just wanted to give you just a kind of a brief history of how my service in the Air Force, just to kind of give you an idea of what it's like to be a veteran, and then tell you a little bit about what it means for me on Veterans Day. So I joined the Air Force Reserve back in 1997, and I was lucky enough to be selected for pilot training. In another month, I'll be hitting my 20th year of service. So, and in being in the Air Force Reserve, that means that I actually signed up to be part-time. But after 9/11, as a lot of the other veterans have experienced here, that our country called upon us quite a bit. And when it's all said and done, I've probably done what would be the equivalent of about 5 years. And I think that kind of goes across the board with any of the service members that are in the reserve or active duty. We've been called upon quite a bit to deploy in support of the different operations that we've involved in. I first started off flying the C-141 Starlifter, which is a transporter plane, and I'm sure there's probably quite a few veterans. Is there anybody that's jumped out of the back for a C-141? So it does a lot of missions. It does transport missions where it carries heavy equipment. It does paratroop operations, and it does also, which I did the vast majority of, is air medevac missions. So what we were involved in is flying wounded soldiers back to a safe location where they could receive proper medical treatment, which was a very special mission to be a part of. After that, the plane, as many of us are getting old, the plane retired, they retired the aircraft and they switched me to the KC-135 Stratotanker. And that's basically just a big refueling gas station. And we can refuel the big airplanes, and we can also refuel the fighter airplanes. And that gives us the ability that we have what's called global reach and global strike. That means that we can put an airplane anywhere in the world and we can keep it over that area for a considerable amount of time. So that tells our enemies that we're fighting against that, that we're gonna come after them at a time and choosing, at a time and place of our choosing. And that's an incredible power that we have to protect our freedom. As a what's called an emergency planning liaison officer. So what I do is I work with other federal agencies in helping coordinate and prepare for and recover from natural disasters, just like we had with all the hurricanes that hit. So I guess with saying all that, what I wanted to bring across is that all of us, all the veterans here, we've served our country in a many, many, many different ways. And the main thing that we all bring the back around to is that we all work together as a team. And I think that's one of the greatest things that we all appreciate about serving the country is the teamwork, the camaraderie, and the community that we're so proud to be a part of. As far as for me, personally on Veterans Day, I reflect back on all the sacrifices that we've made. First and foremost, I have a huge amount of gratitude for those that have given their lives in service of our country. Enough can't be said about that. I'm also grateful for those that have been wounded in the line of duty and that continue to carry the scars, both some seen and unseen, with them to this day. And I also wanted to say that I have an equal amount of gratitude for the families. A lot of times we are out deployed doing basically what we've been trained to do and in almost all instances what we love to do. And the families are the ones that are left behind to pick up the pieces. So I know as far as all the deployments that I've made, that my wife and my children and my family and the community in general have shouldered a huge burden, and I just wanted to take this opportunity to thank them for that. I feel very honored to see you. I think it can be said that we all take pride in serving our country, and I sincerely appreciate the gratitude that you've shown us today, and thank you very much for giving me the opportunity.
much for being our guest speaker. We certainly appreciate that. And thank you also for your service and dedication to our country. At this next time, we are going to allow our veterans to kind of introduce themselves and see who's here. So I'm going to start, if that's okay, because I didn't get to sit on the floor next to my dad and my brother. So I'm going to start right here. This is my brother, Ed Bennett. He's retired from the Army, and I'll let him give his retirement rank and all that good stuff. This is my dad, Jim Bennett. He's a veteran, also in the Korean War, and a veteran of the Army.
Okay. My name again is Ed Bennett. I'm one of our older brothers, and I'm Chief Marshal 4, U.S. Army retired. I had the pleasure of being the aviator she talked about, and I'm very proud of the fact that I got to retire with Special Operations Command in this area. This is my father, Jim Bennett. He was a Korean War veteran, and I'll give the mic to him and pass it on.
Justice Terry. I'm Ray Carey. I served in the 90s in the United States Navy submarine service. I came out second class petty officer, and I'm here also with Jordan Terry.
My name is Sergeant Mark Brown Sealing, career war veteran, and I ain't going back.
Hi, I'm Gary Peters. I'm a lieutenant in the U.S. Navy. I'm here with Cameron Peters, 1988 graduate of the Naval Academy, and I currently work as an engineer for the Coast Guard.
I'm Ed Johnson, Corporal of the United States Marine Corps, proud father of Abigail Reese.
This is my granddaughter, Rihanna. United States Air Force, Senior Master Sergeant, retired. Thank you.
I'm Josh Davis, President of the U.S. Air Force. I'm a professional linguist. I'm here with Lieutenant Jackson.
Master Sergeant Warren Vernon, retired U.S. Army. I was drafted in 66, during my 2 years, got out, stayed out 6 years, gave up 3 stripes, went back in, served out the rest of my 20 years and 22 days. I was a personnel specialist, airborne infantry, 10 soldier at Fort Myer, health physics technician, and preventive medicine. This is my grandson, Roman.
So Steve Lucas, I was in the Navy for 11 years. I was sent to my Navy civilian, so I worked with the Navy, the Army, currently working with the Marine Corps. Good to be here, first thing, sorry guys, I'm not at home. But I'm here with my son, David.
So, I'm Corporal Jose Seiko, Melissa's disabled father. I served with 38 for the Battalion of Marines at the University of North Carolina. I read a few veteran, and thanks for having me.
I'm Anthony Gitti. I served with the U.S. Army. Airborne Division, 101st Airborne Division, and 5th Corps in the Army.
Good morning. My military family will call me Tech Sergeant Jones. My civilian family calls me Mr. Jones. My wife calls me Damon. I'm proud to serve in the United States military. I've been in the Guard for 16 years, Operation Iraqi Freedom, as well as Operation Enduring Freedom in Afghanistan. Proud to serve, and I'm here representing my fourth grade class. Where are you at, class? All right.
Colorado Springs and stationed on the 48th Island. Most recently in the U.S. Virgin Islands, helping with disaster response down the U.S. Virgin Islands, going to Puerto Rico here for the students of the Lakes of Death. I'm here with my beautiful daughter, McKenna, and I want to say thank you to all you veterans for supporting the families as well.
Hello, my name is Jeffrey Bernhardt. I'm here with my daughter, Maggie. I joined the Navy in 1990, and I left in 2008 as a lieutenant. I would say this name is my former officer.
My name is Bill Wood. I served in the Army from 69 to 71 in Vietnam as an MP, and I'm here with my granddaughter, Madison Seville.
I'm here with third grader Dorothy Williams. I served in the Air Force as a staff sergeant in the Iraq and Afghanistan wars as an air pilot.
My name is George MacDonald. I'm here with my son Henry. He's a Cub Scout for us week living anymore. I served in the U.S. Navy. I was a signalman second class on the USS Midway, forward to Fort Mitchell.
I served in the Air Force as a air ground operations in Vietnam, and I want to thank all the kids for coming and honoring veterans.
I'm Jake Hopkins. I'm here with my two proud grandkids, Mark and Brian Reese. I'm a retired Lieutenant Colonel from the United States Air Force, and I currently teach professor at the Naval Academy.
Vietnam veteran, very proud of it, here with my grandson. Hi, I'm Tarzell, and I'd like to say something to all those Vietnam vets. Haven't been said enough. Welcome home.
We were there.
center for the store, that one center. Just listening to all of that experience, I'm humbled to be in the presence of these brave men and women and boys and girls and ladies and gentlemen. I think we owe a deep appreciation to the sacrifices they've made. I'd like to thank all of you very much. Boys and girls, as we leave this assembly today, I really want you to think about the fact that Veterans Day is a day when we pause to give thanks to the people who have fought for our freedom and our safety. And please keep our veterans and active duty service members in your hearts and never forget that we are here and we are free because of them. Called The Pride of Our Country by Roger Robichaud. Today, as before, our brave do fight for a land they love, a flag so right. Pride of our country, yes they are, the strength of our nation, best by far. Just as our brave, from each war gone by, they march for us proudly, flag held high. From all over this land, they come to serve, they're taught by the best, this they deserve. When troops give their all, the world does see, whether serving on land, in the air, or at sea. The pride from this country marched through war with homegrown strength held deep in their core. Our best are so awesome, their loved ones well know. May God guide their journey where they go, for us, where they go. What these brave must have is support from their own. The love from their people, firm thankfulness shown. Our greatest achievement is that we're still free. Please take in time and ponder all of these who caused this to be. Thank you so much for your time.
This concludes our Veterans Day observance. We thank you so much for coming. Thank you once again. Can't say it enough to our veterans. Students, if you would please turn to your teachers, and I think third grade, let's focus on you guys getting out of here first so you can make sure you get to lunch.